In this video, we'll demonstrate how to obtain, import, and process LIDAR data files with SMS, which can then be used to build an SRH 2D model. LIDAR is an acronym that stands for Light Detection and Ranging. It is a type of data gathered by remote sensing. As a data source, it is becoming fairly common and accessible. The United States Interagency Elevation Inventory makes it simple to acquire this data within the borders of the United States and its territories, and is open to the public. In the bottom right corner, we can control what types of data are shown on the interactive map. There are several types of elevation data here, including topographic, shoreline, and bathymetric data. To acquire elevation data for an area of interest, first make active the data you need, in this case, topographic LIDAR, and click the blue Identify button. Then click on the area of interest, and available datasets will be highlighted on the map and listed in the top left box. The listed datasets can then be expanded for more information, and links to sites where data can be downloaded are provided in the data access field. We will use a previously prepared LIDAR file containing points that were merged from previously downloaded LIDAR data files. We'll start by importing the LIDAR file into SMS. SMS recognizes the LAS file extension as LIDAR data. The data contained in the LIDAR file can be quite complex and extensive. The LIDAR Load Options dialog gives options to specify which data and how that data is imported. Under Load Type, we'll select the Point Cloud option. This is a quick method for importing points that will later be converted to a scatter set. The elevation grid type will create a raster from the LIDAR data and is a slower process. It is generally recommended to use the point cloud type. If the LIDAR file is very large, we can limit the number of points that are imported using LIDAR point classifications. These point classifications are used to group different surfaces that are defined in the LIDAR file, and make it possible to import only the data defining the surfaces we need. However, point classifications are not perfect, and care should be taken when using this feature. Additionally, LIDAR data typically does not return bathymetry or bed elevations beneath the water surface, so areas covered by water often must be obtained using alternate data collection sources. In the Return Type section, we'll select which return types to keep. Since we are interested in data that most likely represent ground elevations, we'll check the Single and Last types. Click OK, and the data will then show up in the Graphics window and in the Project Explorer under GIS Data. Now that the elevation data is imported into SMS as an image, we will need to convert it to a scatter set by right-clicking on the image under GIS Data and using the Convert to 2D Scatter command. Using the scatter set, we can examine the quality of the surface. One thing to check for is points that obviously have incorrect elevations. Looking at the contours, there are a few points with elevations far outside the reasonable range for this area. Rotating the display into a 3D view can show this as well. We can select and delete these points from the scatter set. After finishing edits to a scatter set, it can then be used with a mesh generator coverage or interpolated directly to a 2D mesh. Rasters can also be interpolated directly to a mesh, but without first converting to a scatter set. As previously mentioned, rasters are created from LIDAR files by using the elevation grid import type. Once both the raster and scatter set are interpolated to the 2D mesh, we can compare the interpolated data sets. The data set defined to be the mesh's elevation can be changed using the Map Elevation option in the Data menu for the Mesh module. Note that the different import methods for LIDAR data can have significant impacts on elevation dataset used for a 2D mesh. The 2D mesh is one of the most important parts of an SRH 2D simulation, and an accurate elevation dataset is key to building a good model. Before closing, we will discuss filtering 2D scatter sets. Oftentimes, scatter sets have more points than are really necessary to define the elevation surface used for building a mesh. A convenient tool to eliminate unnecessary or redundant points from a scatter set is to use the filter tool. The goal of filtering is to reduce the total number of points to a workable level, but not delete too many points such that accuracy is compromised. The filter tool targets areas of an elevation dataset where the interpolated surface is relatively flat and has more points than are needed to define that flat surface. The filter options are found in the Data menu for the Scatter Set module. The user input for filtering algorithm is an angle in degrees. When a scatter set is filtered, SMS examines all the triangles and creates a line normal to each triangle face. For each point, the filter angle is compared with the angles formed by the normals of the triangles connected to the point. If the angle formed is less than the specified filter angle, then a point is considered redundant and deleted. So, the higher the angle, the more points will be removed. A reasonable value for the filter angle is typically about 10 degrees or less, but an appropriate value depends on the area being modeled and the level of accuracy needed. We will give an example by specifying a 5-degree filter angle. When the process completes, we see a summary of how many points were removed. A good approach is to start with a small value between 1 and 5 degrees, and then examine the result. The filtering can be repeated with larger angles if needed. In conclusion, the various options for importing LIDAR files combined with powerful edit and filter tools that SMS provides can be used to facilitate processing and using elevation data with SRH 2D models. This concludes the importing LIDAR data video. Please visit the Federal Highway Administration's website or the SMS wiki pages to learn more.